Good morning.
Good morning.
Hi, Rosa Irma. Good morning. How are you?
I'm fine. And you?
Fine. Sleepy. You? Are you sleepy?
Yes, very well.
¿Durmió bastante bien?
Sí.
Vaya que me alegro. Me too. Okay, sí, estoy un poco cansadita de dormir.
A veces siempre uno duerme y siente que como que no ha descansado, ¿verdad?
Y hay veces que usted duerme poquito y siente que ha descansado bastante. Ya me ha pasado eso.
Sí.
Ay, sí, porque sí, toca bien pesado en la semana.
Súper pesado.
A mí sí me toca bastante pesado.
A mí también. Sí.
Sí, y ayer fue a las votaciones.
Sí, fui ya casi ya en la tarde ya.
Sí, sí estaba algo lleno, ¿verdad?
Fíjense que donde a mí me tocó, me hice una pequeña colita, pero no así como, no estaba tan.
Y no me acuerdo. No me acuerdo a dónde exigió la gente que les abrieran el centro de votación como a las 9 de la noche.
En San Marcos, creo que fue.
Y más ahí les iban a dar fuego si no hacían caso.
Sí, como a las 9 estaban ingresando de 25 en 25 las personas.
Es que la gente, sí que ayer andaba bastante gente ahí. Sí, pero bien, bien. Bien, gracias a Dios que no hubieron muchos disturbios.
Sí, solo.
Peleas nada más, a discusiones. Pero bueno. Primeramente Dios no trascienda, ¿verdad?
Sí.
Ay, permítame que se me olvidó encender esto. Ok, everybody. Good morning, Pablo, José y Juan José. José Roberto. Morning, good morning. And Sara is here too. Good morning, good morning. Let me see. Today is class number 13. Ya casi terminamos el módulo, chicos. No me vayan a faltar mucho de hoy en adelante. No me falten. Ok, porque aquí me estaban dando como el reporte de minutos conectados y todo eso. Entonces, algunos ya no pueden faltar de, como les digo, tener menos minutos. Los minutos de clase son 120. Creo que les mandaron, ¿verdad? El promedio. Se los mandaron.
Lo de los minutos de clase no lo he dicho.
Solo el porcentaje.
De asistencia, sí.
Sí, ese es el que. Sí, así que vamos a estar pendientes de eso. Ya poquito nos falta. ¿Ok? Poquito nos falta. Well, we're going to begin. Let's see. I'm gonna share the list. Okay, so you can see your attendance, and I'm gonna take attendance. Let me check. Okay, there it is. Comenzando una nueva semana, gracias a Dios que estamos vivos. Okay, Campos Reynosa, Pablo Ernesto.
I'm here.
Okay, very good. Hugo Gil no ha venido todavía. Juan González.
Present.
Okay, very good. Sara Jacobo.
Good morning, I'm here.
Good morning, Sara. Good morning. Okay, Carlos Humberto Lima, not here. Luis Fernando Linares. Ahí está conectado. Luis Fernando. Ahí está, there he is. Pero no me ha dicho present, pero vamos a ver acá. Isabel Mejía, not here. Ana Patricia Melara, not here, todavía no. Ok, Carol Membreño, not here. Rosa Irma Méndez.
Present.
Rosa Irma Méndez, always.
Present.
Always, always present. Present. Ah, Luis Fernando, yes, don't worry. Ya le puse present, ¿ok?
Ay, sí, se me había trabado un poquito.
No se preocupe, don't worry.
Thank you.
Ok, Danilo Morales. Danilo Morales no ha venido todavía. Nelson Quintanilla. Erwin Rivera.
Present.
Ok, Raquel Sierra. Not here. Andrea Ticas.
Good morning.
Good morning. En José Roberto Vázquez, Francia.
Good morning.
Nice. Se acaba de conectar. Ana Patricia Melara.
Good morning.
Good morning. Very good. ¿Cómo les fue el fin de semana? How was your weekend? How was your weekend? Was it good or was it tiring?
Good.
Good. Good weekend. All right. Did you go to El Tunco Beach? No.
No.
No. For vacation. You will go for vacation. Okay. Very yes. Good. Okay. Nice, nice, nice. Okay. I have a question, everybody. Dijimos que íbamos a repasar los números, ¿se acuerdan?
Yes.
You told me, and algunos me dijeron que no se sabían mucho los números. Okay. So today I'm going to bring, I have... as an introduction, okay, para que vean los números. I have for you a little bit of the numbers, okay? So, ahorita se los enseño, right? I'm gonna show you the numbers right now y lo vamos a repasar, okay? So you learn a little bit about numbers. Okay, very good. Give me a second. Porque estos les sirven a ustedes. And it is important that you learn them. Okay, well, the numbers, vamos a aprender del 1 al 100, all right? Si nos podemos del 1 al 100, nos vamos a poder hasta el millón. Okay. So, the numbers are these. For example, how do you say, well, you have the numbers from 1 to 10 here. All right, lo que hay que ver es cómo se escriben. How do you write them? Okay, for example, how many brothers do you have, Pablo? How many brothers and sisters do you have?
Two sisters.
Two sisters, only two sisters. No brothers, Pablo?
Brothers.
Hermanos, brothers? No, hermanas.
No, only sister.
Oh, so two sisters and you, one boy.
Yeah.
Wow. Yeah. Okay, very good. Juan Jose, how many brothers and sisters do you have?
Just a brother, teacher.
Oh, just one brother. Okay. And Rosa Irma, how many brothers and sisters do you have?
Two sisters and two brothers.
Okay, two sisters, two brothers. And Luis, how many primos, how many cousins do you have? Luis. Fernando is okay.
Yeah.
How many brothers and sisters do you have?
No, don't have many brothers and sisters. Only eight.
Only?
I.
Oh, okay. So you say, I don't have any. Any brothers or sisters. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
And you can say, I am an only child. Only child. Hijo único, right?
Yes.
Okay, very good. You are an only child. Sarah, how many brothers and sisters do you have?
Two sisters.
Two sisters. Only two sisters.
Only two sisters.
Okay, very good. Juan Jose, how many brothers and sisters do you have? Sorry, Juan José Roberto. José Roberto, how many brothers and sisters do you have?
I have two brothers and one sister.
Two brothers and one sister. Okay, very good. How many pupusas do you eat, everybody? How many pupusas do you eat? Can you tell me? Edwin, how many pupusas do you eat? Edwin is here, right? Let me check. No, he's not here. Andrea Ticas, how many pupusas do you eat?
I eat two pupusas.
Only two?
Yes, only two. Okay.
And what about is Raquel? How many pupusas do you eat?
Morning.
Morning.
I eat two pupusas, two.
Two pupusas, two. All right, very good. And you, Juan Jose, let's listen to a boy. Maybe they...
I eat three pupusas.
Three, only three.
Yes.
No, and
kind
and
of.
No... Ah, okay. It depends if pupusas are small or are big.
Yes.
For example, los planes pupusas, how many do you eat?
Three.
Three, all right, all right. And in a regular pupusa like this?
Four or five.
You see? Okay, very good. And let me see, Danilo, how many pupusas do you eat?
Two.
Sorry?
Two.
Two. Okay, very good. So if you see numbers, okay, los números nos sirven para contestar preguntas como esta. How many? Con how okay. much también, pero ya van a ver cómo. How many? All right, very good. For example, how many brothers do you have? Okay. How many sisters do you have? Etc. Okay. Very good. Do you have? So, esta es una función de los números. This is one function of numbers. Okay. So, from 1 to 10, right? Yo creo que todos nos sabemos los números del 1 al 10. So you say 1, 2, 3. You don't say 3 because it's not árbol, right? It is 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. What about the numbers from this to this one? What's this number? How do you pronounce this number? How do you pronounce this number?
11.
Excellent. Very good. 11. Okay. Then the next one.
12.
Very good. Now, el siguiente número, the next number, denota o indica que usted ya, que esa persona o ese niño, right, pasó de ser niño a ser un teen. Okay, very good. The meaning of teen is adolescente. So, 13. It's like if you say this, I will show you. Third, como que si usted lo dijera con Z. Este sonido, guárdelo porque lo vamos a ocupar. All right? Third, 13. Okay? 13. Then we have the next one. 14. The emphasis is going to be in teen. Don't say 14. No, 14. Okay? How do you pronounce this one? Everybody, how do you 15. Pronounce?
15.
Excellent. 15. You have to emphasize that. The next one?
16.
16. Very good. The next one?
17.
17. The next one?
18.
All right. Teen. All right. The next one?
19.
And 20. Okay, you can, this can be pronounced in two different ways. You can say 20 or you can say 20. What do you prefer, 20 or 20?
20.
20. All right, very good. It's easier. So, a partir del 20, hay que aprenderlo de 10 en 10. Okay, very good. So, you say 20. How do you say 25?
25.
25. How do you say 28?
28.
28. Very good. 28. Then we have, how do you pronounce this one?
30.
30 or 30. 30. All right. Very 30. Good. Excellent. Pero este sonidito, ¿se acuerdan que les dije? Este sonido hay que reciclarlo en el sentido de que es bien utilizado. All right. So we're going to say 30. Then we have 40. The next one? 50. The next one? How do you pronounce this one?
60.
60. How do you pronounce this one?
70.
70, or some people say 70. So you choose. Yes, you choose. If you say 70 or you say 70. Because people say 71, 72, 73, 74, all right, 70, 70, 70. The next one?
80.
80, okay. Then we have?
90.
90, and then we have?
100.
100, okay. Estos son los básicos para aprendernos bien. Porque después, later, I'm going to show you. Ya solo hacemos esto. What's this number, everybody? Tell me, what's this number? Leanme ese número. How do you read that number?
13.
No, this
120.
Excellent. 120. All right, very good. 120. How do you pronounce this one?
2,234.
No, 2,234. 234. All right, 234. Vaya, se fija. Ya podemos ir diciendo otras cantidades, pero sí no sabemos del 1 al 100. All right. How do you pronounce this one?
156.
Ajá, 156. Okay, what about this one?
178.
178. Okay, vaya, de ahí podemos ir cambiando la centena, right? Y podemos decir, este, por ejemplo, ¿cómo sería? 400, right? 400. Yes, how do you read that number?
439.
Excellent. 439. And then how do you read that one?
790.
Excellent. 790. All right. Let's see. What about this one?
698.
Excellent, Rosa Irma. 698. And how do you read this one?
999.
Excellent, very good. 999. Y de ahí viene el
1,000.
Excellent, 1,000. Se lo voy a escribir en este cuadrito en blanco. 1,000. Este sería 10,000, 100,000, and then we have 1,000,000. Okay, very good. So 1,000, 10,000, 100,000, and 1,000,000. Okay, ahora vamos a empezar a decir frases un poquito más grandes. Let's see. How do you read this? How do you read that, everybody? Okay, I'm gonna tell you. Como ya tenemos 1,000 acá, entonces hacemos esto. 1,340. Okay? 1,340. Leemos primero la, la milésima. All right, very good. So let's see. I'm gonna write another number. Okay, how do you read this, everybody? How do you read that?
140, 60.
Not 100.
1,100.
Exactly. 1,450. 1,450. Milésima, centena, decena, unidad. Okay, very good. So let's see. I'm gonna write another. Eso le están enseñando a mi hijo a colegio y aprendí yo también. How do you read this, everybody? How do you read that one? A volunteer?
1,500.
No, repítelo, tranquila, no se preocupe. Que esto, estos números sí quiero que me los manejen bien porque me imagino que ustedes manejan números también, right?
Sí.
Yes or no?
Yes.
Ok, entonces vamos a aprenderlo bien ahora, pero tranquilo, vamos a ir despacio. Ok, Carol, help me, please.
1,500.
Excellent.
67.
Excellent. Very good. Acuérdense que este es el 100. Ok, this is the 100. Ok, let's see. No se preocupen que vamos a ir a practicar después. Vale. Cambio este a 2,000, teacher. Ah, this one, 3,000. This one, 4,000. This one, 5,000. Okay. How do you read this one? A volunteer?
6,789.
Excellent, Rosa Irma. Very good. Nice, nice. Nice. Okay. Let me see. Let me see. Luis, can you read this number, please? Luis Fernando can help me. Luis, are you there?
Yes.
Okay, Luis, can you read this number for me, please?
Okay, 7,451.
Excellent, Luis. Very good. Excellent. Ok, vale, le vamos a ir subiendo los numeritos sin miedo. Por eso les dije yo, hay que aprendernos del 1 al 100 bien y de ahí las milésimas. 1,000, 10,000, all right? Y eso es fácil. 1,000, la palabra 1,000 reina en las cantidades de 1,000. Porque ya no se dice de otra manera. 1,000, 2,000, 3,000, 4,000, 5,000, 100,000, 100,000, 350,000, 350,000, all right? Very good. En la, de ahí ya no se va a tener que aprender otra palabra. Solamente 100, 100, 1,000, 1,000, million, 1,000,000, ok? Very good. Aquí solo es no tenerle miedo a las frases largas, a los números largos. A volunteer. Un voluntario, un valiente para leer esa frase, all right? Esa cantidad. A volunteer or victim?
14.
Ah, volunteer, Nelson. Ah, ¿me quiere ayudar, Nelson? O me estaba diciendo good morning, sorry.
Ok. 13.
This one. No, Nelson, this one. Ok, give me a second. Le voy a pedir otro voluntario, porque acaba de entrar, ¿verdad, Nelson?
Yes, es que tengo problemas con mi computadora.
Ah, vaya, no se preocupe, perdón que ya lo estaba agarrando yo así en...
pero
como
puedo ayudar.
Como en curva. Ah, ok.
Puedo ayudar, puedo intentar,
yes.
A ver.
Ok, vaya, démosle. Pues. How do you read this?
El que está marcado, el 10,000.
Ese, cabal.
ahí sí me agarro en curva.
Vale, ok. Que les digo a ellos que para decir cantidades así de grandes, ya grandecitas, tenemos que aprendernos los números del 1 al 100, all right? Creo que lo más básico sería aprendernos del 1 al 19, de ahí de 10 en 10, porque de ahí estos 45, 45, ocupo los primeros. De ahí 100, de ahí me voy aprendiendo 1000, ahorita se los escribo, 1000. ¿Cómo se escribe 1000? Ok, very good. 1000, ok. Y de ahí el 1,000,000. Or 1,000,000. Ok, 1,000,000. 1,000,000, ok, very good. All right, so aquí tenemos 10,000, right, everybody? So we're gonna say, a volunteer. Let me see, or I will choose. Raquel, all right. Raquel, help me, Raquel.
10,345.
Ah, okay. Repeat this one, Raquel.
10,000.
Excellent. 10,000.
345.
Excellent, Raquel. Very good. 10,345. Okay, very good. Let's see. I'm gonna write another. Okay. A volunteer for this one. Voluntario para esa cantidad.
74,789.
Ajá, very good. So Juan José, this one is
74,000.
Very good. 74,000. Okay, very good. 74,000. Let's see another volunteer. No, let's see. Okay. A volunteer for this one.
98,000.
Pablo. ¿O quién es? Pablo es. Ajá. No, ok, Pablo, go ahead.
Es que otro compañero también.
Ah, otro era. ¿Quién era? Sorry. Erwin.
Ay, no, yo.
¿Quién era?
Danilo.
Ah, Danilo. Ok, Danilo, go ahead.
98,000. 753.
Excellent. Very good, Danilo. Okay. And how do you read this one, everybody? Vaya, el número que viene, ¿este qué número es? What number is that? Everybody?
100.
Okay. ¿Y qué pasa? What happens si hago esto?
100.
No. 100. Tranquilo, no, sin miedo, con miedo o sin miedo a equivocarse, porque estamos aprendiendo.
100,000.
Very good. 100,000. Para llegar al millón nos falta un cero nada más. One. Okay. So you have 100,000. Very good. 100,000. So, let me see. Y si tengo esto. Ok, ¿cómo lo voy a leer? How am I going to read? So, we have 100. Le voy a leer ese para que vean el ejemplo. 100. Ok, como aquí ya tenemos una centena, right? We have to say 123,000, uy, 456, okay, 123,456, okay, very good. Let's see, hoy les pongo uno yo. Give me a second. I'm gonna erase these numbers. Okay. Let's see. Vaya, vamos. Sin miedo al éxito. How do you read that number? A volunteer. Un valiente, a volunteer.
456,789.
Very good, very good, Juan José. Excellent. 456,000. La coma en esa frase significa el mil, ¿ok? So 456,789. All right. Decir números grandes, I like it. Okay, very good. Let's see. A volunteer for this one. José Roberto.
Yes.
Okay, José Roberto. Tell me that number.
500,067,345.
Oh, okay. Repeat this one, please.
5,000.
100.
100. Okay.
Uh-huh.
567,000.
Excellent.
345.
Okay, excellent. Very good. Very good. Ajá, aquí ya no podemos tener thousand, okay, sino que 100. Ajá, 567,000. Excellent, José Roberto. Nice.
Okay.
Okay. Let's see. What about this one? Estas son cantidades como de precios de casas. How do you read that one? How do you read that one? A volunteer for this one?
300,000.
Yes, Ana Patricia. Very, Ana Patricia, was?
Yes.
Right? Yes, you say 300,000. Oh my God, look at this house. It's very beautiful. But it's 300,000. Oh my God, that is so expensive. Okay, how do you read this one? Everybody, how do you read this one? Yes?
50,000.
Uh-huh. So 50,000. 50,000. All right. 50,000. Aquí no tenemos 100 porque no hay otro número acá. Okay. So we have 50,000. All right. Lo voy a mandar a practicar. ¿Alguna pregunta? Solo de práctica. I mean, it is practice, but do you have a question? No? No questions, everybody? Ok. ¿Se acuerdan que también los números nos sirven? Ok, numbers are for saying. También nos sirven para decir edad. Ok. And the question for the age is, how old are you? How old are you? Ok, very good. So, for example, yo creo que no les he preguntado eso. I don't know your age, or yes. I don't remember. Okay. Raquel, how, or yes. Raquel, how old are you?
I am 26 years old.
Oh, Raquel, you are young. Okay, very good. Juan José, how old are you? Juan José, how old are you?
Sorry, teacher.
How old are you?
I'm 31
years old.
Who are you? Mm-hmm.
Okay, very good. Carol, how old are you?
I'm 36 years old.
36. Ah, yeah, you and I are the same age. Okay, yeah. José Roberto, how old are you, José Roberto?
I'm 23 years old.
Oh, you are young. Very good. Excellent. Okay. Ana Patricia, how old are you?
I am 29 years old.
29 years old. All right. Very good. Cuando, when is your birthday?
21
July 21st. All right, very good. Oh, yeah. So yeah, March, April, June, July, in 3 months.
3 months.
Yeah. Danilo, when is your birthday? I'm sorry, Danilo, how old are you?
Okay. I 45 year old.
Oh, okay. Mi, pero se le oye la voz bien, bien, bien young. Yeah, okay. Thank you. Say, yeah, so you say am. You can say am or I am. Okay, very good. Tengo una pregunta. ¿Por qué no podemos decir I have? ¿Por qué no podemos decir I have, everybody? Do you remember?
No idea.
¿Les han explicado alguna vez por qué no? Why do we have to, ¿por qué no podemos decir I have? Porque I have es yo tengo. Y como en español decimos, yo tengo tantos años. So, why is not possible to say I have? A volunteer? Que sepan o no saben?
I don't know.
You don't know? Okay, vaya, ahorita les digo. It is not possible to say I have, because I have es como que usted tenga algo físico, right? Have something physical in your hands. Oh, look at this. I have a little bunny, a stuffy bunny. I have it in my hands. Por eso es que no podemos decir I have years old, porque los años no los andamos en las manos, es mostrando. Ah, miren, aquí tengo 25 años. No, right? So that's why we say I am. And also because it's personal information. Okay? Very good. All right, let's see. ¿Para qué nos sirven también los números? Nos sirven para decir prices. Prices, for example, how much is a car? Okay, everybody, how much is a car? An average. Dígame un promedio, an average of price. How much is a car? Can you tell me, everybody, how much is a car? Everybody? ¿Cuánto vale un carro en promedio? Sorry? 6,000. Okay. Another price. Depende de muchas cosas, de la marca and everything, but okay, you have 6,000.
In average.
Uh-huh, an average. Mm-hmm. I think an average is not 5,000. Depends, right? 5,000. Uh-huh, 3,000 if you want something comfortable, all right, 3,000, etc. So, the question para hacer la pregunta del precio es how much. How much, okay, very good. How many is for answering numbers like this, and how much is for price. Okay, very good. Now, si quieren, tómenle una foto, take a picture to this, porque vamos a ir a practicar, we're gonna practice. Vamos a practicar dos cosas. We're going to practice two things. Ah, and pay attention. When we use questions, cuando hacemos preguntas, when we use questions with how many, la palabra que sigue después de how many tiene que estar plural. It's not correct if you say, how many brother? No, how many brothers? How many car? How many cars? How many TV? How many TVs? All right. The word has to be in plural. And then you say, do you? How many TVs do you have? How many cars do you have? Okay. Very good. Okay. And for the price is how much? Okay, very good. Do you have the picture?
Yes.
Okay, very good. Bye. Entonces ahorita vamos a ir, we're gonna practice, right? Some things. Bye. Vamos, me van a hacer dos cosas. We're gonna do two things. Number one, me van a, en grupo, all right? Van a pensar tres preguntas con how many. Okay, very good. Three questions with how many. And three questions with how much. Okay, very good. Uy. Okay, we have one, two, three. Okay, you will think. Las de how much, acuérdense, son así. Por ejemplo, ustedes me van a hacer preguntas como how much is a tablet, for example. How much is a tablet, everybody? Usted piensa en un precio promedio, no marca específica. No, no, no. How much is a tablet, everybody? How much is a tablet? Can you tell me?
200.
Two.
200.
200, all right, very good. 200, 300, right? Etc. Very good. And here, how many? How many tacos do you eat? How many tacos do you eat? Okay, very good. How many? How much? All right. And number two. Y lo segundo es que le voy a poner unas cantidades para que practique. Ok. Uy, sorry. I'm gonna write algunas cantidades para que practique decir los números. Ok. Le voy a poner con decenas, right? Hundreds. I'm gonna write hundreds. Mm-hmm. I'm gonna write thousands. Necesito que me practique esos números para poder decir bien cantidades in English. Okay, give me a second. Wait. Ok, en le voy a poner unas cantidades algo grandes. All right. Hay que practicar de todo. Ok, very good. So maybe you can take a... You can take a picture, all right, about this. Okay. Okay, everybody, please take a picture from this because we're going to practice. So, vamos a hacer dos cosas. We're going to do two things. Number one, think about three questions with how many, three questions with how much, and after you practice the numbers. Is it clear, everybody? Is it clear?
Yes.
Very good, excellent. Nice, 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 nice. Sí, de esta clase van a salir sabiendo bien esos números. Okay, I want you to read the quantities very well, porque después les va a servir mucho, a lot, a lot, a lot. Okay, so we're gonna go and we're gonna practice in mini groups. Mini, mini groups. Okay, very good. Let's see. Okay, I'm gonna give you some minutes. Vamos a, le voy a dar tiempo. Ok, recuerde, usted nomás entre al breakout room, comparte la imagen, así aprovechamos el tiempo. Ok, go. Thank you very much.
Hijos serían...
O children.
O children.
Children.
Sons. Teacher.
Hijo.
I have a question.
Yes, tell me.
Children. Plural sons.
Oh, the plural of sons.
Mm-hmm. Sons.
Or if, yeah, or if you want to say, for example, hijos, niñas y niños, you can say children, como los niños, así, niños cualquiera, y niños, los hijos de uno. Okay. You say children, si no quiere ser específico. Digamos que tiene dos niñas y un niño. Y usted no quiere decir, I have two daughters and one son. Usted quiere decir que tiene tres hijos. I have three children, ¿ok?
A question sería, how many children
do you
have?
Excellent.
Do you have?
Perfect. Yes. Excellent.
Perfect.
Yeah. Okay. Hello, Raquel, en Rosa Irma, en Connie.
Hello.
¿Ya terminaron? You finished.
No.
Es que están calladitas.
Es que estoy pensando, una consulta. How many shoes have? Is that correct?
Ah, you can say how many pairs of shoes do you have?
Do you have?
How many pairs of shoes do you have? Okay. Yeah.
Perdón. Repeat, please.
Ah, okay. Give me a second. Ahorita se lo escribo aquí. How many pairs of shoes? How many pairs of shoes? Do you have? How many pairs of shoes do you have? Yeah.
Do you have?
Yes.
Okay. Thank you.
Okay. Okay, everybody. Practice, all right? Practice, okay. Practice. Rosa Irma, are you there?
Yes.
Okay. Tal vez pueden compartir la pantalla para practicar después los números. All right?
Okay.
Okay.
intervención a cargo de Jessica Ábalos de revista FAP.
Everybody, did you finish practicing the numbers? ¿O les faltó un poquito de tiempo?
Faltó un poquito.
Ah, ok. Vaya. ¿Cómo estamos con la estructura de preguntas? Ya lo voy a escuchar. I'm going to listen to you in some moments.
Ok.
I'm going to give you more minutes. Le voy a dar unos cuantos minutitos más para que practiquen los números, ok? Is that okay? Very good. Okay, nice. All right, very good. Estas prácticas nos sirven bastante, everybody, estas chiquitas. Y después que ustedes nos vayamos a practicar a grupos pequeños, que vengamos de nuevo para que todos podamos opinar, right? Eso le ayuda, helps you a lot. All right, very good. So I'm going to give you more minutes, like four minutes is okay?
Okay.
Okay, very good. Okay, very good. Very good, and let's go.
Your house, please. How much is your house, please?
I don't understand.
My house is an average 25,000.
25,000. Andrea, how much is how much is your house, Andrea?
My house on average 27,000.
7,000. Okay. Por otro lado hemos puesto how much.
Esteban,
creo que se desconectó. Hola,
hola.
I am here, everybody. I am here. Okay, es que alguien me estaba pidiendo el link de clase. Tal vez alguien me pueda hacer el favor de mandarlo, please.
Okay.
Alguien se quiere conectar. Thank you very much, because I don't have it at hand. Le voy a decir que ahorita lo mandan al grupo. Thank you.
Listo.
Thank you very much. Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Okay, ese es el link, ¿verdad? De un solo los manda ahí. Bye. Okay. Well, everybody, do you have your questions? Yes. All right.
Yes.
Okay. So you will practice the questions. You will practice some questions with me first. Okay. Very good. So volunteers to ask me questions. Ask me. Practice with me.
How many people do you house?
How many people live in my house?
Yes.
Oh, let me see, 1, 2, 4. 4 people and me. So we are in total 5 people. Mm-hmm. Another question? Go ahead, another question.
How many coffee cups do you drink?
In one day?
Yes.
Two, only two. Yeah, it's because I have problems with my... how can I tell you? If I drink a lot of coffee, I get very hyper. Like, yes, I get very hyper. So no, I don't drink coffee. Okay, another question.
How many beers did you drink?
I know.
It's a difficult question.
Yeah. Do you want me to be honest?
4 six pack.
No. I drink, let me see, 8 or 9.
Ah, 2 mm-hmm. six pack.
1.5. Yes, very good. Yes, you know, I am not like the thing is that I'm gonna tell you something. The thing is that when I drink beer, I drink and eat. I mean, so I don't have like, because a lot of people only drink, and that's why they get like very, very dizzy. But no, not in my case. I don't have that problem.
Ah, okay. Yeah,
it's very delicious. Ah, yes, it's very delicious. Why not? Okay, another question. Ask me questions, everybody. Del Connie.
How many pairs of shoes do you have?
Uy, Connie. How many pairs of shoes do you have? Like, I don't know, like 20?
Okay.
Like 20 pairs of shoes, yeah. But 20 pairs of shoes, like sneakers, sandals, yeah. Formal shoes, different kinds of shoes.
Okay.
Yeah. And you, Connie, how many pairs of shoes do you have?
Six. I have a shoes, a sport.
Oh, sneakers.
Okay. Sneakers. So you don't
like tacones? You don't like high heels?
And solo para ocasiones especiales.
Ah, only for special occasions.
Okay. Yeah. Pero I have a two pair formal shoes.
Ah, okay. So in total, you have six.
Uh-huh.
Ah, okay. All right. Very good. Excellent. Very good. Okay. Another question, everybody?
How many coffee cups do you drink?
Two in one day. And you, Sarah?
I don't like coffee.
Really?
No, I don't like it. Oh, never.
You never like it. Excellent. I don't like it. Perfect, Sarah. You remember. Very good. Another, Rosa Irma, ask me a question.
How many do you have a car?
Yes, I do.
How much is your car?
It costs 6,000.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. 6,000.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay. Another question, everybody?
I have a question.
Raquel, ask me.
For the numbers.
Ah, de los números. Okay, tell me.
How you say 5,500?
5,500.
5,500.
Vaya, lo puede decir así, esa es una manera. No les he querido decir la otra manera porque es un poquito complicated. But I'm gonna tell you. 5,500, like this.
Yes.
Okay, very good. Yes, five, like this. Pero también ellos dicen así. Por ejemplo, si tuviéramos 10,000, los North Americans, ellos suelen decir así, mire. 10 hundreds. 10 veces 100. 10 hundreds. Uh-huh. Yeah, that's what they say. 10 hundreds. Es otra manera de decirlo, right? 10 hundreds. Ajá. Yeah. Okay. Okay. Yeah, that is, but you say 5,500. That's the way you say it. 5,500. Okay, let's see. Luis Fernando, ask one question to one of your classmates. Please, Luis Fernando.
Sorry, teacher, one question.
Oh, ask one question to one of your classmates.
Okay.
You choose Sarah, Connie, Rosa Irma, Danilo.
Hugo Gil.
Ah, okay. He has just gotten online.
Okay. Entonces, Carol, Yamilet.
Carol, all right, ask a question to Carol. Okay.
Okay, Carol, cualquiera de many, much, cualquiera.
Cualquiera, la que usted quiera.
Okay. How many child do you have?
I have one child.
Okay, very good. Luis, you say how many children?
Ah, ahí tenía dudas. Si
exacto, sí. Children es hijos. Children.
Okay, thank you.
Very good. Okay, very good. Niños y niñas, no importa, all right? Doesn't matter. Pero si solo son niños, sons. Si solo son niñas, daughters. Okay, very good. Carol, ask one question to one of your classmates. Please.
Okay. Danilo.
Danilo. Okay, Danilo Alcides.
Hello.
How much is a cell phone?
Okay, Danilo. Listen to the question Carol asked you.
Excuse me.
Carol, repeat the question, please.
Okay, how much is a cell phone?
My cell phone is
Or maybe, Danilo, not your cell phone. A normal cell phone, I mean. Un celular, ¿cuánto vale? How much is a cell phone? You can say an average price.
224.
Okay, 224. Ay, very specific. you sell cell phones, Danilo?
Yes.
Ah, that's why. Por eso que fue bien específico ese precio. Very good. 224. Very good. Excellent. Okay. Now, ¿quién tiene la imagen de los números? Porque a mí se me borró. All right. No puedo grabar acá. Solo tengo esto que me preguntaron. But maybe one person can share the picture with the numbers, please.
Okay.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you, Danilo. All right, very good. Now, I need volunteers. Necesito un voluntario que me diga la primera línea de números. The first line of numbers. The first.
Volunteer.
Okay, Rosa Irma, help me. The first one. Go ahead.
45, 17A, 22. 15, 19, 68, 89.
Okay, Rosa Irma, repeat 78, please.
58. 78.
Yes. 50
es 58. No, but excuse me. 68.
60 is 68.
60.
Ajá, 60 es 60, right? How do you say 70?
60.
Ok, 60 es 60, 70 es 70.
78.
Excellent. 32. 32. 32. Uh-huh, 32. 16. How do you say 16 in English?
16.
Excellent. 16. 78.
78.
Uh-huh, 70 or 70? 78.
78.
Okay, very good. But 70.
78.
Excellent. Very good. Very good. And 89?
89.
Thank you. Thank you, Rosa Irma. Okay. Okay. Remember, 70 or 70. Okay. Very good. Excellent. Thank you. Now, para la segunda, for the second group, a volunteer. Or victim. What do you think?
Hi.
José Roberto or yeah. Erwin.
Los dos dijimos, pero...
Ajá, okay. Now.
Dale, José Roberto.
Jose Roberto, go okay. ahead. Thank you very much.
¿Yo? Okay.
Yes. No, no, you.
Okay. Y entonces, 123, 345, 678, 789, 765, 342. 564.
Very good. Excellent, excellent, excellent. Okay. Another volunteer for the next block.
Yes.
Esto ya están un poquito. Okay, very good. Okay, Erwin, go ahead.
1,345, 4,678, 5,899, 70,198.
Okay, sorry, sorry to interrupt you. Can you repeat that one, please?
5,899
No, el 7,000.
Ah.
Can you repeat that one, please? Uh-huh.
70,000.
Seven.
7,000.
Ajá, because 70 is 70, okay? Yes, yes. Ajá.
7,198, 5,456, 3,546.
Excellent, Erwin. Very good. Nice. Okay, the next one. Aquí se voy a necesitar varios voluntarios, all right? Uno por uno, one by one. Volunteers or victims? You choose. Okay, I will choose. Sorry? Juan José. Okay, Juan José, read the first one, please. Lea el primero, the first one.
75,789.
Excellent, Juan Jose. Very good. All right. Now, another person. Okay, very good. Entonces, ahora ya empiezo con victims. Andrea, can you read the second, please?
23,789.
Excellent, Andrea. Perfect. You got a 10. Okay, let's see. Nelson, help me with the next one, please.
Okay, 67,819.
90. Excellent, Nelson. Very good. Nice, 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 nice. Carol, help me with the next one, please. Tranquila, ese está un poquito más largo, pero no se preocupe que yo le ayudo. Okay.
Okay, es...
Esto lo vamos a
234.
Ajá, ajá.
678.
Ok. Almost perfect, almost perfect. Nos faltó algo. ¿Qué representa la coma? What does the coma represent? Thousand. Solo esa palabrita nos faltó. Ok, repeat, repeat, please.
200 is 34,000.
Ajá. 678. Excellent, Carol. Very good. Nice. Perfect. Okay. Perfect. Okay. Let's see. Let's see. Let's see. Let's see. Sarah, can you help me with the next one, Sarah? Please.
5,046,007,089.
Okay, Sarah, aquí al revés, okay? 500, ajá.
46,000.
Exactly.
786,89.
Excellent, Sara. Very good. Nice. Excellent. Okay. Let's see for the next one. Will help me, Pablo. Do you want to help me?
Okay.
Okay, Pablo.
three hundred forty-five thousand and two hundred thirteen.
Excellent, Pablo. Very good. Perfect. And for the last one, a volunteer for the last one. Let's see, I'm gonna look for a victim. Erwin, do you want to help me, Erwin? For the last one, please.
Yes, yes. ¿Cuál va, perdón?
El último, aquí.
Es 60,000, 57,500, 43.
Excellent, very good. I'm very, very, very happy for that, okay? Very good, very good, okay. Nice, thank you very much, Danilo. I will stop this, okay. Perfect, nice, 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 nice. Mañana le voy a hacer un examen de esos números. Okay, very good. Now, we're gonna practice. Vamos a ir a unas conversation questions. Uy. We're gonna go to some conversation questions, and these are some conversation questions with how often do you. Okay, I'm gonna give you some expressions that we can use. We can say I always, I usually, usualmente, I sometimes. I never. Okay, very good. So we're gonna use these expressions. Para contestar estas preguntas, vamos a usar estas expresiones, these expressions. Okay, I always, I usually, I sometimes, and I never. Y obviamente complementando la pregunta. For example, how often do you travel? Juan José, how often do you travel?
What is often?
Ah, often. How often is cuán a menudo? How often? Cuán a menudo viaja usted? How often do you travel?
I sometimes.
Okay, you say, I sometimes travel. You will tell me the complete sentence, all right? I sometimes travel. So, or you can, a veces. Sometimes is a veces. Always y siempre, right? You can say, ah, teacher, I always travel, yeah, in my vacation. Or you can say, I usually, usualmente, I usually. Or I never, no, teacher, I never travel, no money, no money. Is it clear? Yes or no?
Yes,
yes, very good, okay. Yes. So, si hacemos un repaso por las preguntas, vamos a ver, algo que no sepan, me pueden preguntar. For example, Nelson, can you read this question? Solo leerla. Can you read it, please? Porque después la vamos a ir a practicar.
How often do you wake up in the middle of the night?
You understand this question, everybody?
Yeah.
Yes, very good. How often do you wake up in the middle of the night? Okay, Luis, can you read the next one, please?
How often do you go to the dentist?
Excellent, very good. Carol, can you read the next one, please?
Hello. How often do you go to church?
Excellent, very good. Nazareth, can you help me with the next one, please?
How often do you eat? How often do you eat candies?
Excellent, Nazareth. Thank you very much. Erwin, can you help me with the next one, please?
How often do you go to the doctor?
Excellent. How often do you go to the doctor? All right. Acuérdense que son preguntas. Tenemos que darle esa entonación. All right. How often do you go to the doctor? Or how often do you go to the doctor? All right. Very good. Pablo, can you help me the next one? With the next one, please.
Okay. How often do you say I love you to your parents?
Excellent. All right. How often do you say I love you to your parents? All right. Thank you. Let's see. Rosa Irma, help me with the next one, please.
How often do you take your English book to study?
Excellent, Rosa Irma. Bien la entonación al final. Study? Okay, very good. Nelson, help me with the next one, please.
Okay. How often do you practice sport?
Excellent, Nelson. Thank you very much. Jose Roberto, help me with the next one, please.
How often do you brush your teeth?
Okay, teeth.
Teeth.
Very good.
How often do you brush your teeth?
Excellent, perfect. Así es la pronunciación, porque si decimos teeth, estamos diciendo otra cosa. Estamos diciendo chichi, all right? Yeah, si usted dice teeth, no, teeth. Okay, very good. Let's see, Andrea, help me with the next one, please.
How often do you listen to music?
Excellent, Andrea, thank you very much. Let's see. Let's see. Okay, I will repeat. Juan Jose, help me with this one and this one. And this one. With three questions, please.
How often do you read?
Okay.
How often do you go to the shopping mall?
Okay.
How often do you buy clothes?
Excellent. How often do you buy clothes? All right. Let's see. Hugo Gil, are you there? Hugo Gil, ¿está por ahí? Hugo. Hugo. Okay, Carol, help me with the next, please.
How often do you eat fast food?
Okay, the next one, Carol, the next one, please.
How often do you have English class?
Okay.
How often do you go out with your friends?
Thank you, Karen. It's a Carol. Thank Karen, I was going to say. Thank you, Carol. Thank you very much. Let's see. Erwin, help me with the next, please. With the next three.
How often do you go to the movies? How often do you go for a walk? How often do you use the internet?
Perfect. Perfect intonation. Very good. Okay. Now, para practicar estas preguntas, de la misma pregunta sale la respuesta. For example, si usted me pregunta, teacher, how often do you go to the shopping mall? I sometimes go to the shopping mall. All right. De la misma pregunta, usted saca respuesta. Okay. Very good. All right, take a picture, please, porque lo vamos a ir a practicar. We're gonna practice, all right? Acuérdese que la práctica es todo. Practice is everything, all right? Very good. You have the picture. Everybody, do you have the picture?
Yes.
Excellent, very good. So I'm gonna stop the share and we're gonna go and practice, all right? Very good. Ok, pero ahora vamos a hacer algo diferente. We're gonna do something different. Ok, Andrea, escoja dos classmates para practicar. Two classmates, Andrea. Andrea, ticas. Andrea. Okay, let me see. Danilo, choose two classmates to practice.
Erwin.
Erwin and?
Carol.
Carol. Okay, sí. Very good. Okay, what about José Roberto Vázquez? Choose two partners.
Pablo.
Ajá.
Otro más, quiero ver.
Love you, Gordon. No sé.
Raquel.
Raquel, all right, very good. What about Juan José?
Connie.
Connie, yeah.
Isabel.
Isabel no está ahorita. Isabel is not here.
Luis.
Luis Fernando. Okay, very good. Excellent. What about Nazareth? You have Andrea, Nelson, Rosa Irma.
Rosa Irma.
Ajá.
Connie.
Oh, Connie, ya la pidieron por ahí.
Pablo.
Pablo también.
Ok.
Oh, Rosa Irma en Nazaret. That's okay.
Okay.
Okay, very good. And the last one, ese va a ser con Andrea, Nelson y Sara. Okay, very good. I'm going to give you some minutes para que practique con alguien que ya conoce, para que se sienta en confianza. Okay, very good.
Nos dejaron tipo el PDC.
¿Cómo?
Los últimos que ya no quería.
El PDC. Ay,
frito.
Ay, no, ya me hizo reír. El PDC. Okay, go. Go, go, go.
Okay, siguiente, next.
How often do you say I love you to your parents, Robert?
Yeah, I usually say I love you to my parents.
Only grandmother.
Okay, my grandmother.
Hello. Hello, Danilo.
Hello, teacher.
Ahora ya lo uno a un grupo, ¿ok?
Ok, gracias.
Give me a second. ¿A quiénes conoce de sus compañeros?
Erwin, Nelson.
Erwin. Ah, ok, ahorita lo mando con Erwin, ¿ok?
Ok.
Yo quiero ver si está Nelson por ahí. Ah, no, pero ellos ya están en tres. All right, I'm going to send you with Erwin and Carol, ¿ok? Okay, very good. Let's see. Pablo. Pablo Reynosa.
Yeah.
Can you do me a favor? Okay. Ask one question to one of your classmates, pero no de su grupo. Hoy de otro. Terminaron. Did you finish?
Sí, como tres faltaron.
Okay, very good. Okay, Pablo, choose, ask one question to another classmate that was not in your group. Okay?
Connie.
Connie, okay. Ask a question to Connie.
Connie, how often do you go to shopping small?
I never. I don't like the shopping.
You never go to a shopping mall?
No.
This woman.
Soy rara.
Soy rara. No. No. There are, hay mujeres que no les gusta. They don't. I don't like it.
Les comentaba a Juan José y a Luis de que me gusta mejor ir a una playa, a una montaña y no morir de shopping en algún lugar.
Ok, very good. Sí, por eso es que cuando dijo que solo tenía zapatos deportivos, dije yo, wow, she's a very relaxed woman.
Yes.
Yes, that means you don't have like, I'm gonna go and buy this and buy that.
Ay, no.
Ok, very good, nice. Ok, Connie, thank you, Pablo. Choose one question and ask another classmate, pero que no sean los compañeros con los que estaban. Okay.
Creo que me salí. No, sigo aquí, ¿verdad? Ah, okay.
No, aquí está.
Es que vi que se me cerró la pantalla, permítame.
No, you are here.
Nazaret Mariana.
Okay, Nazaret.
Yes. How often do you say I love you to your partner?
I always love you, my parents.
Okay, very good, Nazaret. Okay. Ask one question to another person, please.
Okay. Andrea Ticas.
Andrea, okay, Andrea Ticas.
Hi.
Yes.
How often do you listen to music?
I sometimes listen to music during the night.
Okay, very good, Andrea. Okay, ask one question to another person, Andrea. Go ahead.
Carol.
Hola.
Okay, ask a question. Ask a question, Andrea.
How often do you go for a walk?
I sometimes go for a walk.
Perfect. Very good. Nice. Okay, Carol, ask one question to another classmate, please.
Nelson.
Okay, Nelson.
Hola.
How often go to the doctor? Perdón, how often do you go to the doctor?
Okay, Nelson, how often do you go to the doctor?
I usually go to the doctor.
Okay, very good, very good. Nelson. Okay, Nelson, ask another person, please.
Okay, Erwin.
Erwin, go ahead, Erwin.
Here.
Ahí está, por ahí está. Okay, go ahead.
How often do you practice sport?
Sometimes practice.
You sometimes practice sports?
Yes, with my daughter.
Ah, for example, what kind of sports do you practice?
Bájate de ahí, porque me traté. Eso no lo agarré. My favorite sport.
How old is your daughter?
2 years.
Ay, mi niña linda. Yeah. Ahorita ya va a entrar a los terribles dos, así le llaman los psicólogos. Es como la how can I tell you? Like pre-teenager. Ajá, es como que sean como que si les agarrara la adolescencia en ese ratito.
Yeah, yes.
Por eso que son así, no le va a hacer caso.
Ah, no.
Ay Dios, dígalo. No. Ocupe la psicología inversa mejor, dígalo, hágalo para que no lo haga.
No me funciona.
Nada. Ay, más que es una como niña.
Le doy más alas.
Sí, ay, los niños, pero ellos son lindos. Right, very good. Okay, Erwin, choose one more, the final question. Un voluntario más, and we finish.
Yes. José Roberto.
José Roberto.
Hi.
Okay, ask the question. Uy, sorry. Go ahead.
How often do you eat fast food?
Perdón? How often do you eat fast food?
How often do you eat fast food?
Never. Oh, bueno, I sometimes eat fast food.
Fast food is comida rápida.
Uh-huh. I sometimes eat fast food.
You sometimes eat fast food?
Yes.
Okay, very good.
Es
very
raro. Good, very
good. Okay, nice. Yo soy raro.
No, es raro que coma.
Ah, yo que digo. Okay, very good. Yeah. Sí, es. ¿No le gusta la pizza, hamburgers?
No, prefiero la comida casera.
Oh, okay, very good. Okay, very good, nice. Está bien, that's okay. Okay, well, now I'm gonna move to a question that is very, very, very interesting. For you, in your opinion, everybody, what are the qualities of a good employee? ¿Cuáles son las cualidades? What are the qualities of a good employee? De un buen empleado. What are the qualities? So I... okay, very good. An employee, a responsible employee. Okay, another?
Organized.
Okay, very good. An organized employee. What else? Everybody?
Honest.
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 An honest. Employee, very good. An honest employee. ¿Ustedes se acuerdan de cómo usar los artículos a en an? Do you remember?
Yes.
Okay, very good. A is un artículo cuando la palabra o el sustantivo, porque no se puede usar con adjetivos. When the noun begins with a consonant. Okay, en an is when the noun begins with a vowel. But my question is, ¿por qué a Ones le he puesto an y no le he puesto a?
Si aquí le because it's a consonant.
Yeah, but the rule says que con consonante tenemos que poner a. Pero si h es consonante, ¿por qué puse an? That is, okay, that is the thing.
La h es muda.
La h no suena. Y por eso ponemos an. It's like an honest. How do you say caballo in English, everybody?
Horse.
Horse.
Oiga, ¿cómo se escucha la h? Horse. How do you say casa in English?
House.
House.
También suena house. Pero ¿y si yo digo honesto? Honest. How do you say hora?
Power.
Ahí también aplicaría eso, de poner an y no a. ¿Is it clear? Les explico por si ustedes dicen, ah, pero ¿y por qué ha puesto an ahí la teacher? Si es clutch, es consonant. Yes. Pero en pronunciación no suena, así que an, an honest. What about another? Otra cualidad, another quality of a good employee. Good employee. Tell me.
Fair, a fair employee.
Justo, very good. A fair employee. Excellent, I like that one. A fair employee. Okay, what else?
Punctual.
Ah, very good. A punctual employee, very good. What else?
A friendly employee.
Okay, very good. A friendly employee. Very good. Que ande contento, ¿verdad? I mean, no contento, but es amigable, right? A person you can talk to and, ah, yes, this person is here, this person is there. Okay, what else? Otra, another quality. Muy bien, llevamos siete, vamos.
Efficient.
An efficient employee. Excellent. Very good, Juan José. Okay. What else?
Proactive employee.
A practical. Practical?
Yes.
Okay. A practical employee. All right. Very good. Okay. What else? What else, everybody?
How do you say puntual?
Puntual, number five, a punctual. A punctual employee, yes. Punctual, excellent. Okay, another person, everybody. Otra, another.
Teacher, how do you say presentable in English?
Very good. You can say a tidy employee, pero eso ya sería más como physical appearance, ¿verdad? Vamos a poner a tidy employee and a good looking employee. Tidy es que se mire limpio, pulcro, right? Yeah, a tidy employee. Okay, porque usted está representando una empresa, you are representing a company, so your personal image is very important. Okay, what else? What else? ¿Qué más? What else?
Trabajador, ¿cómo se dice?
Oh, how do you say trabajador in English? Hard working. Employee. Okay, very good. Hard working. Excellent. A hard working employee. All right, very good. Otra, another.
Efficient. Ah, ya está.
Yeah, is this number seven? Yes. Only that, everybody. Solamente eso. Only that.
How did you say confiable, teacher?
Ay, very good. A reliable employee. Confiable se dice así. Reliable.
Reliable.
And confident, que es que guarde como discreción. A confident employee, right? Very good. Very good. A confident employee. Very good. Okay, we're gonna just leave this. We're gonna collect these ones. Take a picture. Take a picture, everybody, from this. Because we're gonna do something later. Okay. ¿Puedo borrarlo? Can I erase? Ya casi terminamos. Oh my God, se nos voló la hora. Se nos voló la clase. Ok, ¿puedo borrarlo? Can you erase it?
Yes.
Very good. Mientras más ocupados estemos en practicar, menos vamos a sentir, all right? Very good. Porque sí, la práctica tiene que ser suya, yours. Yo solo le doy las herramientas. I give you the tools and you use the tools. Ok. Now, well, it says let's go to the manual here. All right, very good. Give me a second, everybody. Give me a second. All right, very good. Give me a second. No me aparece ahí. Acá está. Oh, okay, very good. Now, I have a question. Are these actions good or bad? What do you think?
Bad.
Is this good or bad?
This is good.
Mire lo que le ha puesto ahí. Kick me. Pateame. Kick me.
Bad. It's bad.
It's bad.
This is not good, right? This is not good. What about this one? Is this good or bad? Que un jefe haga esto con uno. Is this good or bad?
It's bad.
That is
very,
not
very bad.
Very, very, very bad, right? Porque todos tenemos dignity. Todos tenemos dignidad. Everybody has dignity. And if dignity is touched, it doesn't matter. Yeah, because you have a dignity. So if a person is shouting on you and that is not good, right? What about this one?
Bad.
Okay, very good. Este sería mocking, burlarse de alguien. Mocking at someone. Ajá, así sería esto. Mocking at someone. Frases que podemos usar con esa, con ese verbo. No, no me haga burla. Don't mock at me.
Don't mock at me.
Ajá, don't mock at me. Como que no te burles de mí. Don't mock at me. No te burles de tus compañeros. Don't mock at your coworkers. Okay, no se burle de sus compañeros de trabajo. Don't mock at your coworkers. All right, very good, etc. Este sería como shouting at people, como gritarle a la gente. Sería don't shout, no me grites. No me grite. Don't shout at me. Okay, very good. Don't shout at me.
I have a question.
Yes, Rosa Irma.
When a person yellow is gritar yellow. No.
Yes. I understand. It is don't yell at me. Este es un sinónimo, Rosa Irma.
Ok.
Mm-hmm. Don't yell at me. Ok. O cuando, por ejemplo, a veces uno está hablando y la gente le hace a uno, shh. Ah, no. Don't hush me. Don't hush me. Ese hush es shh. Cuando la gente le hace a uno así, shh. Hey. Right? Hey, don't hush me. I don't like it. Don't hush me. Ok. And this one is joking, bromeando aquí, joking. Okay, don't joke. Mira, no bromeas conmigo. Don't joke with me. I don't like it. No me gusta. I don't like it. Don't joke with me. Now, cuando se logra un nivel de confianza con alguien, you can do it, right? But not with everybody. No a todo el mundo le gusta. Not everybody likes it. Okay? Is it clear? Very good. Tal vez le puede tomar una picture porque esto es lo último que vamos a hacer. All right, this is the last thing we're going to do. Voy a pasar la lista. Do you have the picture, everybody?
Yes, teacher.
Very good, excellent. So voy a pasar la lista y de ahí pues we're gonna finish. Gracias a Dios hemos estado ocupados, han estado practicando. I'm very happy for that. Okay, let's see. Okay, Hugo Ernesto Gil Rivera.
Present.
Okay. Connie Andres.
Here, teacher.
Okay. Nazareth Aide Mariona.
Present.
María Isabel Mejía. Rosa Irma, Danilo Morales.
Present, teacher.
Nelson Quintanilla.
Present.
Raquel Sierra.
Present.
Okay, very good. Well, my dear students, thank you very much. Hoy estuvo, a pesar de ser lunes y que uno dice, oh my God, pero hemos estado, trabajaron muy bien, lo felicito, congratulations. Le voy a mandar un audio de tarea, quizás ya en unos minutitos, para que lo puedan hacer durante el día y me manden el score cuando puedan, ¿ok? Sí, well, sí. Thank you very much, everybody, and have a nice morning. Bye-bye.
Bye, teacher.
Take care. See you. Have a nice morning. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.